Hey, how's it going there?
How you doing? This on you.
What are you up to today?
Oh, not a lot.
Trying to stay out the heat. I don't blame you.
Okay. Put my gloves on. Get started. When was the last time you had a haircut?
A few weeks ago.
And then, do you use anything to style your hair?
Occasionally, yeah. You can go ahead and style it as well if you want.
Do you like shiny pomade or
more of a matte, I think.
Okay. Let's see. Let's go first. All right. Your hair kind of has a natural part in it, so I'm going to try to use that. Pretty hot, so it doesn't feel too bad. How long have you been doing your channel?
Doing my what?
The YouTube thing.
Oh, gosh. Years.
It's like, yeah, maybe I shouldn't tell him that, but I didn't know. Check it out. And I was like, oh, yeah. I had actually seen one of your videos, which is the guy, the Route 66 barber shop. I've seen
him. Oh, Angel, yeah.
Is that guy still there doing his thing?
Yeah, last time we heard he's kind of like isolating because of the pandemic and stuff.
So, yeah. Understandable. What was the last shop you went to overseas?
The last one overseas was in, it was in Kuala Lumpur in Malaysia.
Oh, that's cool.
Was it not Kuala Lumpur? Oh, yeah, Hong Kong.
And it's really sad what's happening over there.
Oh, yeah, with the, yeah.
I went there when I was in the Navy, like, I think twice, but I really liked it. It's one of my favorite visits.
Yeah, Hong Kong is great.
I don't know what it's going to be like now, but hopefully not. Like, you can't go there, but I'm definitely having a hard time right now. I liked it there, and Singapore is another place I like.
Singapore is good.
Have you been, you did a shop over there?
We've not, no, not filmed at a shop in Singapore, but I've been to Singapore a number of times.
Okay. And you're not a barber, right? You just obviously like barbers.
I have not trained as a barber. My thing is the you know, the filming and stuff.
How did you get into that? Like, how did you decide you wanted to do a channel about barbering?
Because I was looking for kind of interactions with the local communities, and it was the barbershops where you can get that kind of genuine kind of interaction with the community.
That's interesting. I'd say that's true.
No, absolutely, yeah.
They'll tell you the facts.
If you want to know what's going on in the neighborhood, you go to the barbershop.
That's true.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. Have you seen the other channels, like the, was it, okay, what's his name, the Barber Man or Nomad Barber?
Nomad Miguel?
Yeah.
Yeah, we actually met Miguel. Gosh, it must have been about 6 years ago now in San Diego.
That's cool.
And hung out for a little bit. It's a cool guy.
Yeah, he seems pretty nice.
Yeah.
He has a shop in, he has a couple.
Yeah, he has, what is it, the one in London and one in Berlin.
I should have went to that London one when I went, but it was like the first part of that trip was trying to just treat like a vacation. Okay. Have you been to a Scorm?
No, we have not. The last time we were in Holland was quite some time ago. And I think that they had just, they were working on their TV series or something at the time.
Oh, wow.
they're cool guys, though.
Yeah, they're awesome. I went to take a class. 2015?
Mm-hmm.
And they're just starting to get it. Thank you. Okay, I'm gonna dry this and then we'll do the rest dry. people hit you up and want like you to come down to their shop?
Oh, like, yeah, yeah.
So it's not always you asking. They usually were like, hey.
It's a blend of different, you know, we're looking for places. We get asked a lot. A lot of times we're, you know, people want us to go. We've had a lot of people say, oh, you got to come down to Brazil. It's been a big one at the moment.
That'd be cool. I mean,
once we can travel.
Yeah, once everything calms down, yeah. That'd be good.
We actually have a Google map we keep of all the suggestions, so that when we're traveling, we kind of refer to that a lot.
And then do you ever ask them, like, hey, we're heading this way, do you know any shops, like, in this country or state or whatever?
Viewers will suggest places, and then if we're in a town, then we will spend time looking around.
It's crazy now, because social media, everybody, like, you don't even have to necessarily have visited that place, you, like, know of it.
Okay. Well, there's a lot of hidden gems with people not on social media.
Right, sure. There are all guys that move away, like there's some state I've never been to, and I'll start looking like for a place for them to go. I'm like, oh, this place looks pretty good. But that wasn't always a thing, you know? Yeah. If you moved away, I'm like, I don't know, sorry. But that's a good point. I'm sure there's a ton of really cool shops that don't use Instagram or Facebook or any of that stuff.
Yeah, it tends to be a lot of the newer places are using the Instagram and Facebook, whereas the older places don't.
It makes sense. When I started doing this, there wasn't any of this. So, I mean, you had the old school just, you know, give people flyers or pass out cards, which I still think is important to do, but it's not as important as it used to be.
No.
In some ways it's easier, but I feel like those things still work pretty good.
Yeah, a lot of the older barbers, they have their clientele and they're happy to stick with it, you know?
Yeah, it makes sense. Just different now. It's just weird. There's just more stuff to use.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Yeah, you'd definitely be wasting your money if you tried to put an ad in the Yellow Pages.
Right. Yeah, it's the same with marketing. Sometimes I'll get people that ask about it, but I mean, a lot of it you can do for free on your own if you're just trying to get people to come to your shop. Before, it wasn't, when I got into this, it wasn't really like that. And then just learning wasn't really as easy as it was. There wasn't a lot of good videos or anything.
Yeah, the YouTube channel is definitely a resource for that.
Yeah, YouTube, I mean, YouTube existed. There just wasn't like a ton of like, especially with barbering, it wasn't popular. I mean, it was kind of where I was living, but like now, obviously, everybody wants to learn barbering techniques and stuff, and there's all kinds of cool videos, but at the time, there wasn't.
Yeah, I think that's one of the cool things with the videos we do, is we find these old guys that have been doing something different, and then we filmed it, and it's like people are kind of watching it and learning from that.
Yeah. Before, you were just kind of at the mercy of wherever you worked, which sometimes they wouldn't want to teach you, which I still think is weird if there's shops doing that. But, like, you go work at a shop and it was like almost like they didn't want you to be good because then you'd be like a threat.
Yeah, that's
just weird, but I've seen it and it's just, I don't get it. But.
That's a kind of a domination thing, I guess.
It was just, people were just very secretive about stuff, and that's one of the good things come out of everybody sharing now, is there's no secrets.
Like, there's definitely enough heads of hair out there for everybody.
Yeah, and that's the other thing, is just, I don't want everybody in Phoenix coming, that would really suck, but as long as people are We have enough people that like it. It's fine.
Quite a bit on top, wasn't there?
Yeah, and there's some areas that are just kind of heavy, so I'm just trying to get them to really blend in with the rest and cooperate more. Barber events and stuff, like when we were doing those types of deals, like
we've not gone to any barber events because we are, you know, technically not barbers, so
yeah, but they would let you, right?
Like, oh,
you
absolutely could go.
I'm sure they'd be more than happy.
Yeah, of course they would. Yeah.
When you met the Scorm guys, they give you a haircut, or you're just hanging and they were around?
Oh, sorry, who was that?
Rob and Lean.
Oh, we haven't met them.
Oh, okay. I thought you said you did somewhere.
No.
Okay. Yeah, they're good guys.
Yeah. No, they were like busy doing their TV series or something when last time we were in Holland, so we didn't
see about
didn't even try to reach out to them.
TV show.
They're actually probably more busy these days than they were then.
I'm sure.
Now, when we were in Holland, we filmed at the Cutthroat Barbershop.
I've heard of that one. Yeah. Is that Amsterdam?
It's in the downtown Amsterdam.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was there. I saw that. It looked like a really cool place, but they were closed. I didn't get to go check it out. But I did go to Van Gogh Museum, that's pretty cool.
Yes.
It's like a long line. We have to get in there. Okay, let me get that. good. Might have to move the
string. So
if you, if you're okay with it, you can take it off from the middle.
Okay.
So I'll be standing like beside or directly behind. Okay. home stretch. Let's get this.
Do you always say do whatever when you go to these shops?
Yes. Yes.
Have you ever been like totally like bummed out after?
No, never.
Never happened?
No.
Surprised? Like what they did? Like you're like, I wouldn't have done that.
I think the one we did in India was not something I would have done, but it was definitely interesting.
What'd they do?
It was like a tight fade on the back, and it was really long and kind of styled, kind of almost like spiky on top. I don't know how to describe it.
I'll have to see the video.
I gotta say, it made me look about 10 years younger, though.
That's cool.
If it is a bad haircut, it really doesn't matter because it'll grow out. So,
it might matter the guy who's in the video, because then like I don't know if you guys get trolled or anything, or if that guy gets any.
It's YouTube. There's always going to be
people out
there.
Yeah, that's true. It's the internet.
Yeah.
It comes with the territory. Wouldn't fight me. This one. used this clay pomade first, but I might maybe use just a little touch of a regular pomade. How many videos do you guys have now?
Not too many. I mean, I think it's about 120 or something.
That's a lot.
Took a while.
Yeah. It's commitment for sure.
Yeah.
What's like the best thing that's come out of it for you for doing these videos?
Well, we get to do this. That's the best thing.
That's true. That's pretty cool. It's a good way to see the world.
Yeah.
Hope we get to keep doing this stuff.
It's definitely a good way to see it changing, that's for sure.
Yeah. Or to hear what other people are thinking about it. That's what I usually get out of it. So we have people that come here from, like, they do all different kinds of stuff. So I kind of get, I feel like, a little more inside information here than I would on TV or anything like that.
Definitely.
Why not? It's just a little bit of this. OCD kicks in. Trying to get it all to go straight back, but I do notice it definitely like wants to part like right in the middle, but I'm trying to do it so it won't let it.
I think mine here has its own little way of doing its thing.
Yeah, and this haircut, I don't think, like, we always try to do whatever the hair naturally wants to do, go with that, which I know it wants to split, but I don't think this is a style that you cannot, like, it's impossible for you to get your hair to do that. I mean, with a little product, but because most people don't want a part right in the middle. Although I do think there's haircuts like that that are cool. It's just kind of not a lot of people wearing them like that. Good. Okay, sir. I'll show you this here. I'll put the mirror behind you so you can see the taper.
Okay. Yep, looks good.
Okay, sir.
Thanks very much.
You're welcome. Have a good Sunday. Stay away from this heat and this virus.
Yes.
Okay, thank you very much.
Take care.